Hi friends, in this video we see about Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction and its problems. Okay, first we see what is electromagnetic induction. A conductor placed in a changing magnetic field causes the production of a voltage across the conductor. It means a conductor moving through a stationary magnetic field, it produces voltage or current. Okay, that means the magnetic field induced the electric current, or the magnetic field induced the voltage. That is called the electromagnetic induction. Okay, so we can simply say that a voltage or current is produced in a magnetic flux. Here one new word is that is magnetic flux. Okay, so what is magnetic flux? In general, flux is the amount of something passing through the surface. Okay, so here magnetic flux means number of magnetic lines of force crossing a closed area. That is called the magnetic flux. Okay, so generally we can write magnetic flux is the product of average magnetic field times the perpendicular area that it penetrates. That is, magnetic flux is the product of magnetic field and its area. Okay, so the magnetic flux represent the letter pi. So pi equal to B dot A. Okay, so pi equal to dot product, so we can write cos theta. So pi equal to BA cos theta. Pi is the magnetic flux. Okay, the SI unit of magnetic flux is Weber or Volt second. Okay, in CGS unit it is represent Maxwell. In CGS unit the unit of magnetic flux is Maxwell, but in SI unit the unit of magnetic flux is Weber or Volt second. Okay, next one, Faraday law of electromagnetic induction. Based on the phenomena of electromagnetic induction, Faraday proposed the two laws. Okay, the first law is the whenever the amount of magnetic flux linked with a closed circuit changes, an EMF is induced in the circuit. That means when we change the magnetic flux, an EMF is induced in the circuit. Here EMF means electromotive force. So electromotive force is nothing but it is an electrical potential for a source in a circuit. That is, EMF means electrical potential. Due to the EMF, the current is flow in the circuit. Okay, so when we change the amount of magnetic flux, an EMF is induced in the circuit. Okay, the second law is the magnitude of EMF induced in a closed circuit is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux linked with the circuit. That means the EMF value, the EMF is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux. Okay, let pi 1 be the magnetic flux linked with the coil initially. Okay, at initial point pi 1 is the magnetic flux in the circuit. Okay, then pi 2 is the magnetic flux linked with the coil after time t. Okay, so after time t means 5 seconds, 10 seconds. Okay, so that is the after time t the magnetic flux is pi 2. Now we write what is the rate of change of magnetic flux. The rate of change of magnetic flux equal to pi 2 minus pi 1 by t. Okay, rate means we calculate by t, then change of magnetic flux is difference, isn't it? So pi 2 minus pi 1. Okay, then this rate of change of magnetic flux is proportional to EMF. That is, EMF is proportional to this rate of change of magnetic flux. Okay, so the EMF is represented the letter E. Then E is proportional to pi 2 minus pi 1 by t. Okay, if t pi is the change in magnetic flux in a time tt. Okay, we take T pi is the change of magnetic flux. So we can write E is proportional to T pi by dt. So T pi by T is the rate of change of magnetic flux. Okay. Next one is Lenz's law. So he was a resin scientist. Okay. He discovered the direction of induced current produced in the circuit. Okay, so when we change the magnetic flux in the circuit, a EMF is induced, isn't it? So Lenz's law found the direction of the induced current. Okay, so Lenz's law state that the polarity of induced EMF is such that it tends to produce a current which opposes the change in magnetic flux that produces it. That means the magnetic flux is, the EMF is opposes the magnetic flux. That is, opposes means negative sign. Okay, so the EMF is negative to the magnetic flux. It opposes the magnetic flux. So suppose we consider in a circuit there are n number of turns of coil, then pi is the magnetic flux, then we can write the EMF E equal to minus T n pi by dt. Okay, here n is the number of turns, is a constant, then we take outside, then minus n T pi by dt. Okay, this the minus sign, here the minus sign represent the EMF is negative, opposite to the magnetic, opposite to the direction of the magnetic flux. Okay, so now we see some problems. Okay, the problem, first problem is magnetic field through coil having 200 turns and cross sectional area 0.04 meter squared. Changes from 0.1 Weber meter squared to 0.04 Weber meter squared in 0.02 second. Find the induced EMF. First you write the given values. Here given value is number of turns. That means that is N. So N equal to 200. Okay. Then area. Area equal to 0.04 meter squared. Okay. Then B1 equal to, that is the magnetic field changes from 0.1 to 0.04, isn't it? So we take B1 equal to 0.1 Weber meter squared, or B2 equal to 0.04 Weber meter squared. Then time T is 0.02 second. Okay, now what is the E value? What is the EMF? What is the induced EMF? Okay, so now we write the equation, and that is E equal to minus T pi by dt. Okay, so in the pi means that is B dot A, isn't it? So here, so we can write minus D N B A by dt. Okay, then we take N A outside, then minus N A T B by dt. So E equal to minus N A. So T B by dt means rate of change of magnetic field. So rate of change of, that means we can write B2 minus B1 by T. Okay, so now substitute the values in this equation. Minus 200 multiply 4 multiply 10 to the power minus 2, that is 0.04 meter squared can be written as 4 multiply 10 to the power minus 2. Then B2 value is 0.04 minus 0.01, then by T 0.02. okay, then calculate the values. We get E equal to 24 volt. That is, EMF is the potential, electrical potential, isn't it? So potential, the unit of potential is V. So we can write E equal to 24 volt. Okay. The next one is, next problem is a square loop of the side 10 centimeter and resistance 0.5 ohm is placed vertically in the east-west plane. A uniform magnetic field of 0.10 Tesla is set up across the plane in the northeast direction. The magnetic field is decreased to 0 in 0.70 second at a steady rate. Determine the magnitude of induced EMF and current during this time interval. Okay, first you take, first here, first you find out what is the magnetic flux. Okay, The magnet, first you write the given values. The given value is B equal to 0.1 tesla, then R equal to, R resistance equal to 0.5 ohm, then area A equal to 10 centimeter, then the determine the EMF value, that is E value, then current I equal to watt. Okay, so now write the formula pi equal to BA cos theta. Okay, here we take theta values 45 degree. Okay, that means the angle theta made by the area vector of the coil with the magnetic field is 45 degree. Okay, so cos theta value is 45 degree. Here substitute B equal to 0.1 multiply A equal to, A is 10 centimeter, can be written as 10 to the power minus 2. Okay, then substitute the value of cos 45, then cos 45 is 1 by root 2. Okay, so in the next step, 0.1 multiply 10 to the power minus 2 became 10 to the power minus 3 by root 3 Weber. Okay. Next one is, now you write the induced EMF formula. So E equal to pi 2 minus pi 1 by T. Okay, here the pi 2 minus pi 1 by T means, that is pi 2 value is 10 to the power minus 3 by root 2. Okay, but the final that is pi 1 is 0. Okay, that is the magnetic field tends to 0 is given in the sum. So we take pi 1 equal to 0, then we substitute the value of pi 2, then 10 to the power minus 3 by root 2 multiply, then T is 0.7. okay, so we multiply both the we simplify this equation, we get 1.0 millivolt. Okay, that is E is the the value of E is 1.0 millivolt. Okay, then then E value we find out, then find the value of current I. So current I is the voltage by resistance, isn't it? So here voltage means we take the value EMF value. Okay, so I equal to E by R, then substitute the value of E, that is 1.0 milli electron volt can be written at 10 to the power minus 3, that is milli means 3, isn't it? So 10 to the power minus 3 by 0.5 ohm. Okay, is the resistance value. So we divide this equation, we get 2 milli ampere. Okay, that's all friends, thank you.